Schedule C is biological and special products. Then Schedule C1 is plant-derived products, naturally occurring products. Schedule D is substance not intended for medicinal use, milk, oats, food, spices. Then drugs and cosmetics imported for manufacture and export by unit situated in special economic zone, notified by Government of India from time to time. Then custom made devices. Then Schedule D1, information and undertaking required to be submitted by manufacturer or his authorized agent with the application form for a registration certificate. The format shall be properly filed in for each application in Form 40. The information for a registration certificate of a manufacturer premises need to be provided in this schedule. These are the details required. Then Schedule D2 is information required to be submitted by manufacturer or his authorized agent with application form for registration of bulk drug or formulation or special product for its import into India. If they want to import, then the manufacturer site details need to be provided. Then the details like drug master file, GMP certificate, the regulatory status of the drug, and the details of the drug dosage form, everything need to be provided, and clinical data. Then Annexure A, information to be submitted in Schedule D2. This is D2. Then Annexure P, information to be submitted in Schedule D2 for diagnostic kit. Then Annexure C for vaccines. Schedule D3, information undertaking required to be submitted by manufacturer or his authorized importer or distributor or agent with the application form for registration certificate. Then Schedule E, list of poisonous substance under the Ayurvedic and Yunani system of medicine. So these are the poisonous substance as per Schedule E1. Ayurvedic system, then B, Siddha system, C, Yunani system. Then Schedule F, requirement for functioning and operation of blood bank and or preparation of blood components, blood bank or blood component. So the building, premises, etc. And then location, surrounding, health, clothing, sanitation of staff, accommodation for blood bank. Then personnel, then maintenance, equipment, it is provided in Schedule F. Supplies and reagents, then good manufacturing practice or SOP for this sterile blood product, and then criteria for blood donation, condition for donation of blood. Then general equipment and instrument for blood collection, for hemoglobin determination, for temperature and pulse determination, for blood containers, emergency equipments or items, then accessories, laboratory equipments, special reagents, then testing of whole blood, then records and labels, then blood donation camp, processing of blood components from whole body by blood bank. How to do that? Accommodation, equipment, what are personal needed, testing facilities, then category of blood component, then processing, then platelet concentrates, what is to be done with that, how the blood is treated, fresh frozen plasma, cryoprecipitate, plasmapheresis, platelet-pheresis, leukapheresis using a cell separator, monitoring for apheresis, then collection of plasma, then part 12c, requirement for manufacture of blood products, then general requirement, ancillary area, collection and storage of plasma for fractionation, then personal testing, production control, viral inactivation process, quality control, testing of blood products, storage of finished product, labeling, records, master formula records, then requirements for manufacture of blood products from bulk finished products, requirement for collection, processing, testing, storage, banking and release of umbilical cord stem cells, Module F1 is for vaccines, provision applicable to production of bacterial vaccines is in part 1A, anthrax spore vaccine, black quarter vaccine, brucella abortus, enterotoxoma vaccine, hemorrhagic septicemia vaccine, all vaccines are included here. Then part 2 is anti-sera. Then part 4 general, then schedule F2, standard for surgical dressing, so surgical clothes, bandage, plaster of Paris bandage, etc. is included in this schedule. Then schedule F3 is for standard for umbilical tapes. Schedule FF is for standard for ophthalmic preparations. Then schedule G is for anti-cancer drugs. Antihistaminic drugs. Then Schedule H drug are the prescription drug. Then Schedule H1. Then these are sedatives, antibiotics, and hypnotics. Schedule I is omitted. J is disease and ailment which a drug may not purport to prevent or cure or make claim to prevent or cure. Then Schedule K. Is the limitations of particular ingredient they have provided. Then Schedule L is omitted. L1 is good laboratory practice and requirement of premise and equipment. So GLP labs follow these guidelines.